My name is Luigi Alberto Cippini, and I direct an emergent architecture studio based in Milan named Armature Globale. And this is a very brief general introduction to Portrait of a Young Planet. So exhibition design is false science. There is nothing that in architecture lead or provide any structures to an active critical installment of what exhibition design can be as a discipline. And Portrait of a Young Planet takes inspiration from an original exhibition designed by Paul Rudolph and curated by Edward Steichen, done in 1955 at the MoMA, the Museum of Modern Art. And it was one of many propagandistic exhibitions in a way created in the US as a counterpart to shame exhibition created and generated in Nazi-occupied Europe. And the main asset that such exhibition brought to us was a general understanding of what propaganda is and how propaganda infiltrates exhibition and display tactics. Another of in a way, main and most cutting-edge facets of that exhibition was the figure of Paul Rudolph, a true American modernist, and in a way, the genetic algorithm for what Americana means. And this exhibition somehow tries to recuperate on that and generate a sort of European demoralization of what Americana is by using parts, pieces, and materials that are actively used in construction sites and construction buildings. And at the moment, they also make the general, basically, structure of a standardized system by which American prefabricated houses are still built. This particular exhibition is a sort of degeneration of a bigger exhibition designed together with Francesco Bonami and Emanuele Mazzonis for the Mudam. And it was meant as a drastic intervention on the brutalization of exhibition spaces, understanding the Mudam as a standard item or a standard architecture environment belonging to what I call a global museum network, a sort of standard genocidal practice that produces exhibition spaces that can only occupy a certain amount of freedom. And the main aim, or in a way the main intervention or the main ideas behind what exhibition design should be today is the possibility to drastically disrupt exhibition and cocooning practices or behavior that is sort of integrated or merged into what artists want. The main responsibility of emergent and small architecture studios actively working with exhibition architecture should actually be to change the perception or to change exhibition tactics from the standards. And the standards of the moment are very sadly, but you can only see artists in their studio, gallery spaces, or booths. And this sort of creates a continuous generalized space that doesn't provide any sort of visual shock nor curatorial trauma. And the main aim of what the exhibition was meant to be was to provide that, to drastically go against the grain of conservation standards, lightning practices, and basically curatorial routines. So what I mostly hate about European cultural institutions is that, such as museums, is that they failed to actively become somehow a technology of doubt. So there's no reason, there's no, in a way, political gain in trying to change the praxis of displaying art. And this has generated a system where there's no difference or there's no shift, so there's no trauma between the creation of an art piece, its market behavior or market biography, and its display history. So in a way, museum stopped becoming sort of algorithm that can change the perception of an art piece, even for a relative short amount of time. And this is why we still have to work on exhibitions such as The Family of the Man, because just after the war, there were incredible possibilities and in a way, incredible adventures in what you could do with art pieces, with copies, and with freedom in itself. And exhibitions like that could actually not be scientifically made again today, because it will go against a general network composed by artist wills, gallery standards, and museum disapproval. And one of the forces behind this show, Francesco Bonami, is still belonging to a generation of curators that sort of perceived the freedom that museums can have. And it was, I believe, one of the reasons why he decided to create a new instance of the show. Emergent Architecture Studio generally use exhibition architecture as a surplus value. So it's free, it's easy, it's short time work, and it fits well in CVs. And the main problem that I see today is that it is used as a proxy for actual work of architecture. And also as a proxy of somehow an embellished ideal of what art environments or interior cultural spaces should be. And so one of the main sort of tasks we incepted with our studio was that at any exhibition design in any institution, no matter what the artist, no matter what the budget, no matter what the brief, there should be an active critical understanding of what means today to show art in contemporary European museums. And so we always sort of, instead of providing exhibiting services, we provide exhibition display brutalization. Because in a way, museums, we always go about their life, but there are moments somehow with different times, in different nations, in different countries, with different artists, where for some short amount of time, you can have a sort of freedom that merges design with advanced curatorial techniques. And you can sort of test with this attitude what museum should be. And this is what we tried to do in this exhibition, which is probably the worst exhibition we ever designed. But at least it works, because one of the things that is missing today is actually the possibility of action. There is a sort of false history that predates past exhibitions in sort of believing that exhibition design and exhibition architecture made in the past were a sort of, in a way, beautiful dimension. And one of the reasons this exhibition is sadly done like that is that the exhibition that actually changed the perception of art during the just during and after the war were the Degenerate Art Exhibition and The Family of the Man. And there were two exhibitions where on one side in Germany there weren't architects actively designing an exhibition, but a congregation of artisans actively using wood. And on the other side, in the United States, you had architects that were working on massive bureaucratic urban projects, sort of designing with the same materials, but with an advanced set of skills. And this has become a sort of standard in the recuperation of the history of art exhibition, where whatever belongs to the past is correct, or whatever belongs to the past can still work today. And what we tried to test was to actually try to use the same materials, the same colors, and the same anti-architecture attitude in the making of this exhibition, trying to merge the same material used by Paul Rudolph and the same, in a way, non-architecture attitude used in Germany. And it was a test on whether exhibition walls or exhibition environment can actively still sustain design or intelligence, because exhibition display and exhibition architecture is not yet configured as an autonomous critical discipline, but is only understood as a service provided by architects for museums. And in a way, it can substitute or alter or augment curatorial tactics or strategies. And we tried that. It seems that we can only do walls. It seems that we can only design with certain measurement in museums for exhibition design. And this is not due to museums. This is due to the fact that the techniques and the construction technology that are available today for contemporary museums are in a way not designed by cultural institutions or cultural practitioners, but they are produced for another market. The general reason why exhibition designs today is generally only made by walls, only made by a certain set of materials, is the fact that the drive for the creation of these construction technologies doesn't belong to the art world, but it belongs to big and huge fairs in European capitals, so such as car fairs or technology fairs. And these set the standards in terms of amount and volume of materials for then a recuperation of all these standard technologies for all other exhibitions. So we can say that exhibition design today is not a thing made by architects, but is a design technology created by commercial institutions. And it seems that the only role left to architects is dismantling of design authorship for gestional routines or procedural routines in the accommodation of a set of intuition and design technologies not made by art. And this exhibition and the former exhibition that was not built was a critical understanding and a critical reading of that. So how could you design exhibition using standards generated by industrial economical structures? And this in a way was our dedication to what was happening in 1955, where material were still undeveloped, and the design by Paul Rudolph or any other architect in the US was meant to be done with the cheapest material possible. One of the main, in a way, curiosity asset that the brief generated in us was still the possibility to do photographic exhibition. And in the former exhibition, to do an exhibition using 1950s technologies to display video art or new media. And for us, it was a sort of correct gap in time. And in a way, the setup and the environment, given the fact that at the end what resulted was a photographic and mixed media exhibition, is truly interesting, because it is another instance of what I believe is the failure of museums and of cultural institutions to actually filter what are the emergent processes in image making. At the moment, exhibiting photography seems a futile effort, given the fact that monitors and algorithmic possibility of distributing images is wider than gallery spaces. And in a way, this exhibition is another stage of, in a way, long research of what are the failures of art environments and how architects can actively produce a critical assessment of that. I see this exhibition as a failed infrastructure, but in a way, a good remark on what exhibition architecture should, in a way, become, or what are the protocols that we should apply in the definition of this discipline as a somehow critical field. Stop.